Hello, I'm Vesco Eskenazi and I'm Concertmaster of the Royal Concertgebouw Orchestra in Amsterdam since January 2000. I started my studies in Sofia, Bulgaria, where I was born. Shortly after, I continued my studies in London at the Guildhall School of Music and Drama. I came to the Netherlands in the 1990s and I started my career here. At January 2000, I became concertmaster of this fantastic orchestra, and I'm proud to be a concertmaster of this orchestra until today. It is an enormous honor for me to be there. I started actually being a concertmaster at a very young age, at the age of 11, in my home country and city, Sofia, in a youth philharmonic orchestra. I started being a concertmaster there. And at the same time, I was also playing solo concertos with my orchestra then. This is exactly what's happening nowadays with me at this age, where I am now at. So actually, whatever I did then, I'm doing now. But I'm so fortunate to be in the Concertgebouw Orchestra in Amsterdam. When I'm not playing the violin and I'm free, I have other things to do, like admiring the nature, for example. I really like to take walks and be on my own in the nature so I can really relax. But funny enough, when I'm there, I still continue to hear music in the birds, in the trees, in all around me. So basically, music is everywhere. In this time of Corona, actually, what I do is I continue thinking about my other future projects, about the orchestra, about things that I never had the time to think about. And actually, that helps me and that will help, I think, the humanity as a whole, if we all do that. In what you're going to see next in this streaming video, you will see me in the role of a soloist with the Royal Concertgebouw Orchestra in the Four Seasons of Vivaldi. That piece is one of the most popular pieces of all times. It is very difficult to go on stage and give it again and again to the people, to the audiences, because it's so well known and everyone is striving to actually show originality or something different every time. I have to tell you, honestly, I started playing the Four Seasons very late in my career. I think I was 35 when I first gave a performance of this piece. And everybody was asking me until then, why you never played Vivaldi The Seasons? I had a very good answer to that, because everyone else plays this piece. When I started playing this piece, I really, first of all, I read all about it, what is necessary to read. But very soon afterwards, I found out that actually what you have to do is to really play the piece from your heart and from all you know about nature, because there's so much nature in this piece. There's so many sounds that you hear outside the cities. And that's why what I told you earlier, I really like, one of the things I really like to do when I'm free is to go and observe nature. Probably that helped me to make a really on my own reproduction of that piece. So what I would like to ask you now is to enjoy the piece, and here is Vivaldi, The Four Seasons.
Hello everybody, my name is Liviu Prunaru, I'm from Romania, and since 2006 I'm playing as a concertmaster at the Concertgebouw Orchestra in Amsterdam. I started playing the violin when I was 6 years old, not very well, in my town, in my native town, Craiova, where I stayed until I was 15, and then I moved to Bucharest to continue higher education. High school and then conservatory. And when I was finally 20, and luckily because our revolution happened in 1989 in Romania, I was able to go actually abroad and continue studying, which I did. I moved to Switzerland, to the International Menuhin Music Academy, where I studied with Alberto Lisi and Yehudi Menuhin himself. I must say that that was a really big change in my life, going to Switzerland and having these two big masters as mentors. And just because maybe I was not a very good student, I stayed for a long time. I actually stayed for 16 years in Switzerland. What do you do if you don't play in the Concertgebouw Orchestra? Well, what do I do if I still play? I play all the time. I play alone. I study. I play for my students. I play little concerts. I play big concerts. I play all the time. And that's also one of my hobbies. When somebody's asking, which is also one of the next questions, do you have a hobby? I have a hobby. I like to fiddle all the time and find things on the violin and invent exercises and have fun actually with the violin. That's really something funny to say about the violin, which is such a serious, and I'm actually very serious when I play. I even look at myself when I see the recordings and I say, why am I so serious? But in the meantime, I have a lot of fun discovering things, and more I discover, more I understand that I don't know anything, in fact. What is your guilty pleasure? Well, my guilty pleasure shows on my belly, and that's eating cakes. I love cakes, I love sweets. And with this, in this situation, we're all now, all this isolation and all of us staying at home with this coronavirus, my wife started cooking lots of things which I didn't expect. And some of them are the sweets, some of them are really nice cakes. And we'll have to go back to playing football and doing sports if we want to continue healthy from here on. Well, I don't think it's really necessary to talk about Piazzolla, because everybody by now knows who Piazzolla was and what he did, because there are so many recordings of his pieces. But from my friends from Argentina, which they all love him, they love Piazzolla there, and they told me that he was such a beautiful man, such a beautiful soul and spirit. And well, you can see that reflected in his music. His music is very speaking. It's very descriptive. It's describing very, very well aspects of the inside, feelings, and as well as facts from the outside, like a simple walk on the streets and simple declarations of love, which sometimes is not so simple, or simply imitating sounds from the nature, like some disturbing birds, for example, like cotorras. What I love about this piece is that it sends you many times to the other four seasons, to the Vivaldi, and I have chosen a few examples tonight, which I'm going to play for you. Each season has a distinct approach and a story to say. The beginning of the autumn, it's very, very interesting for me for these strange sounds which one has to produce on the violin. And it basically shows me a little walk on the streets of Buenos Aires, nonchalant walking, relaxed, carefree, which actually describes pretty much most of the moments I feel like when I go to Argentina, relaxed and happy and sunny and carefree. Another very nice moment I would like to mention here, it's in the second season, which in this case is the winter, Invierno Porteño. And it's so funny because it starts by referring, making a parallel between his own music and to the original Seasons by Vivaldi. And literally he's just copying a few bars here, there, and then you can hear where it comes from. It's very recognizable. But then he immediately makes a beautiful transition into his own music. And that's so geniusly made. It's really, really, really beautiful. And I enjoy that especially so much. I must say that for me, this is my favorite season, the winter, not in reality, but in this situation, the Piazzolla. Winter is, it has the most beautiful melodies, and then you can hear them in this example. Primavera, certainly the most virtuosistic, most virtuoso season from all four by Piazzolla. And here it is, you can hear already the beginning of the opening of this season, how demanding, how difficult, and how virtuoso it is. The last example I'm going to show comes from the Verano Porteño, is the closing season in this case. And one more time, you recognize an absolute identical passage taken from Vivaldi.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.